It's cool. Don't worry about it. I'll fix them up for you. I'll make it something worth using. Okay. Do you want to only use it every once in a while? Like, how many times do you want to be able to use it? Oh, okay. Then we can really crank it up. All right. This is a single target. How weird a dude do you think Keith is? Just like off kilter. All right, there we go. It is. It never went down, technically. Oh, cool. Hi, Steve, if you're watching. Worry about it. For good reasons, yeah.
Choosing, which may or may not have effects on the party. Keith will
What was the
refuse
song?
to. Oh, well, he actually chose. Well, because he actually went up to $20, so he got concert. So
Nice.
he picked three songs: "Land of Confusion," "Bad Boys," and "Yesterday."
Cool. So I will make Land of Confusion a spell you actually get to use all the time.
Cool.
Because that's a good name.
Yeah, I enjoy that. Yeah, that is an appropriate name for a spell. What are you going to do about the other ones?
I'm fixing it up currently.
All righty. Are you able to edit my character sheet?
Yep.
Okay, good. Good, good. Then that'll save me the trouble of stumbling through whatever I need to do. Yeah, and I attempted to, as you can see, I attempted to put in Master of Puppets, but I don't fully understand the character sheet creation thing.
You're doing pretty all right.
All right. Let's see.
Let's say a wall.
Oh,
30 feet long.
and because,
And
oh, sorry.
sorry, 15 feet high? There we go. Okay, sorry, go ahead.
And because he got the $25 donation, he also got up to there was one, which I just realized I'm holding candy in front of stream. Anyway,
Worry about it.
but
So what is there was one?
which includes that, which means that Keith will outright deny the existence of something, and Steve has chosen poison. I don't know does that work?
Sure, yeah, you just don't believe in poison.
All right. Yeah, and
Dumb concept. There are things that can go in you that make you die. What the hell?
that sounds fake. You're
That
dumb.
sounds fake.
Yeah, so Keith just abjectly does not believe in poison, and he will not recognize it. Or not recognize it. He it just I don't know how would you say that would work if he doesn't believe in it? Does that mean
He
that if he
doesn't
gets
believe.
poisoned, it just wouldn't work on him?
He just feels randomly sick.
Oh, okay.
And like, it wouldn't work very well. You probably have advantage on anything involving it.
Good deal.
Where is the team?
I don't know.
They're running late.
Oh, yeah, it's 12:31.
Gonna reach out,
Oh,
see
wait.
what's up.
Andrew's coming in.
On
Here
something.
we go. Hello?
Hello.
Okay.
I don't see you, but I can hear you.
Yeah, I can hear you, Andrew.
That's because I'm going to turn the video off so I can sit in darkness.
Fair.
All righty. Oh, yeah, that would make more sense. Having Master of Puppets be based on charisma instead of...
This is pretty much just a beckon.
Ah, yeah. Yeah, he's just like, come here, or go over there.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Other than that, I tried my best to come up with some spells, but based on, like, names, but
they're definitely not bad. I just, like, they're good concepts. They just need some work.
Oh, yeah, yeah. No, definitely. I have no idea, like, what is best in terms of, like, structure. Oh, yeah, and that should probably be changed up.
It just needs describing what you're actually rolling for.
Oh, well, yeah.
What was this, Land of Confusion?
Yeah, Land of Confusion, Yesterday, and Bad Boys, of course, Bad Boys. The one that I recognized immediately is the one that I forget about.
I won't necessarily tell you what the other ones do, but I will tell you what what Land of Confusion does.
Is it something involving confusion in the enemy?
Yep.
That would make sense. So thank you, Steve. I'm a little conflicted, though, because he unlocked up to, like, the $25 one, I'm not only supposed to play a concert, but I'm also supposed to refuse to play songs for the entirety of one encounter.
I feel like the concert's going to take precedence because you only have a few encounters left.
Yeah, that's fair. I would agree with that, especially since, you know, that's really more of a draw than like being like, no, I don't want to play.
Okie doke. Cool. Don't know if I caught everything, but it's a start.
Yeah.
Aren't we missing Fred and Tom?
So we are. We're also missing Austin, unless he's not coming back. I don't remember where that is.
Well, I mean, Austin. I see Austin in stream, but it says he's disconnected.
Yeah, he's just not here. Mm-hmm. But Fred and Tom are supposed to be here, and currently
and
are they- not.
Yeah, and they are our missing party members.
I have messages out to the two of them, and I don't see a response yet. I will presumably send out a call in a minute.
All right. Did you get, like, everybody's phone number? Or,
well, I mean, I know them.
Oh, well, yeah, the doy.
Oh, Volkovy. Is Volkovy your friend?
Is who?
Volkovy. V-O-L-K-O-V-I-I. Is that your...
Oh, Volkovy. Why do you... I mean, it sounds like Steve, because I remember him talking about Volkov at one point. I think it's a Command and Conquer thing. Why do you ask? I'm not... I can't see the stream. I do have Facebook open, though, so Steve, if Volkovy is you, let me know in Facebook chat. That way I can either confirm or deny that.
Yep, he's saying it is, it's me.
Kono wa Steve da.
I believe I have located the problem with Fred, because...
Is he asleep?
No, he's in a different time zone.
Whoopsie doodle.
And so he's like, yeah, isn't it at midnight? I'm like, yes. I'm like, oh, you're in the wrong time zone.
Ah, shit.
All right, so yeah, he'll be here presumably in a few minutes.
Okay.
Tom, I have no idea. I'm going to give him a call if he does not respond in the next, like, 2 minutes.
Nice. Well, I'm glad that Steve's in the stream.
Someone is messing with the mic.
Yeah, no, I can hear that. It's not me.
Oh, that's, listen. You were just responding with, ah, shit.
Oh, I meant to ask, this Bardic Inspiration thing on my character sheet, what does that mean?
Fair. I don't know if you would know to do it because you don't think magic is real, but generally you can like just throw inspiration to people and give them like some bonuses on the dice.
I feel like if Keith would do that, it would be done accidentally.
Yeah, totally. You could just like say you're encouraging somebody, and then
I'll be like, "Go on, get in like there." Firm pat on the back that's actually filled with inspiration.
Yes, Austin, but I actually have something for you for when we get back to playing. I think it might be time to make your wish. It's okay. We're waiting on two other people anyway. I'm actually going to call Tom now because that way I won't embarrass him in front of the stream.
Yeah, you're not the only one to have.
Nope, never mind. He's just giving the response now.
I'm doing the 24-hour stream with Rick Roth and people that I've been doing all day. And I was supposed to be back 8 minutes, and they're all waiting for me, so I gotta go.
Watch if you want, but yeah. There we go. Bye. Properly framed.
Tell them to eat shit, Johnny.
That's not gonna win him any.
Okay, can you hear me?
Hey there.
Okay, yeah, sorry about that.
Is that you, Austin?
That's me, yeah. All okay, right. So what were you saying about the mall?
What is that? Did you get a new spell? Is that what? Oh, you named it. That's cool.
Yes. It's the Fist of a God.
Nice. So you've got a wish there. Oh, okay. One second.
Excuse me. Did I get a wish while I was away?
Well, no. Remember Miranda had one.
Yeah, but do you like... All right, so...
But I finally decided what to give to you.
What?
I think you should wish for Mjolnir.
The big hammer that Thor uses?
Yep.
The hammer of thunderbolts?
Because, like, I feel like after all this time of having your hammer get shit on by a superior hammer,
might be time to
class up.
Okay, yeah, I was gonna... All right, I will wish for Mjolnir. I cast the spell Wish for Mjolnir.
Well, doesn't he have to be?
I am a mighty mage.
What you saying, Josh?
Doesn't he have to be worthy of the hammer in order to wield it, though?
He's lawful good.
Okay.
He's not a bad person.
He's got a hammer.
You know, I mean, like, I just...
I'm lawful neutral, actually, but whatever. Yeah.
Lawful hammer.
I'm a good dwarf. I was lawful, in the army, the dwarf army, in my time.
What they don't tell you is that you either have to be worthy or have a beard.
Yeah, it's just one or the other.
You know, one of the
dwarfs two. Dwarfs are pretty great.
All right, cool. So yeah, you get your Mjolnir. It functions as a one-handed maul.
Okay.
You can throw it as if it were like you can pretty much make a basic attack at a range and call it back to you. And it does its damage a second time as thunder damage.
Sweet.
Okay. So, Tom, can you hear us?
Yes, I can. Can you hear me?
Loud and clear.
Perfect.
I'm seeing the black screen. Crisp.
I am in. Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Excellent.
All right, cool. Are you supposed to be like just a black screen? Or?
Yeah, I don't have a webcam.
That's okay.
That's fair.
All right.
So, I'm gonna stick with that one for right now.
Yeah, I swapped over to desktop, so I'm not going to have a webcam, but hopefully my turns won't take like 5 minutes as I'm lagging out.
That's appreciated.
Yeah, I mean,
at least you're probably not going to be as bad as I was in the first year we did this.
Like, you were all yelling me to cast Booming Blade, and I was like, I was scrolling in the character sheet, and every time I scrolled, it would like jump down beyond it, and then it would jump back up because the lag delay on the scroll, and it was a mess.
My internet upstairs would only allow me to get in a quick one-liner, and then I'd freeze up again,
which was really funny.
Yeah.
Okay, so for everybody. Oh, Fred disappeared.
There's Fred. He must have disapparated.
Wrong button.
Okay. Know that feeling. All right, so let's go down the group. We'll introduce the people who've been here for a while, and then we'll have the new guys introduce themselves. Because presumably you met on the trail and it's like, it's time to save the world. All right.
Want to help?
Pretty much. Austin, what's your character?
Yes. All right. I am but a lowly dwarf, Brumnar Fizzlebottom. From a young age, I always loved the magical arts, but my parents said, "You are very stupid. You will never be a wizard." So I joined the army and I became a fighter. And then one day, I met a wizard, and I asked him if I tried hard enough, could I learn magic? And really sarcastically, he said, "Sure." And so I took those words to heart, deep into my being, and I studied really hard, and now I can cast very few spells.
At least one.
At least one.
All right, Josh, who are you today? Oh, is Josh frozen?
Dead.
All right, we'll move on to Carson momentarily and get back to him.
Okay. I am Mountaincrag Purehammer from the city of Mountaincrag. In a crag in the side of a mountain. Dwarves are not very clever. And I am a forge priest. I wield the Fist of Moradin, a hammer that grows with the blessings of the gods, and also donations from viewers like you.
Thank you.
And I suppose that I should, you know, destroy this thing that's trying to destroy the world, because then there would be no more world, and I'm one of the people that live there, so that's why I'm on this quest. Also, I have this magic key.
Nice. All right, Josh, what's up?
My name is Keith Troubadour. I am a human who was once a bard. I have come out of retirement because I noticed that there was some asshole doing parlor tricks in the sky, scaring everybody. So I've decided to quest until my belt meets his ass.
Dank. A noble cause. Goodbye, Matt.
Keith does not believe in magic.
Despite many people wanting to believe in this collective idiocy that things like elves and magic and dwarves exist, I know the real truth. Those are people with birth defects, children who glued hair to their faces, and smoking mirrors.
You can't cheap tricks me. That hurt people.
It's a trick!
Anyway, Tom, who are you today?
I am the fan favorite Secox and Mendacious.
Oh shit, you're back!
Oh, I'm back. I'm back, and I have a cape.
Oh, nice.
Not another cape.
Nice. All right. Is there anyone here who doesn't know who's... Actually, for the chat, who is Secox and Mendacious?
Secox and Mendacious is the world's greatest pirate.
Just ask him. He'll tell you.
Here for noble purposes, noble goals. Going to guide this party in the correct direction.
Nice.
Just I missed ask half him. Of that.
He'll tell you.
Because everybody disconnected.
Don't worry about it. And most likely you disconnected because we heard each other.
Saw you, man.
Oh, well. Go ahead.
So, I'm a mimic.
with an eidetic memory, so I can remember a bunch of people. And so right now, I'm basically just going to switch people on the fly during, I don't know, things. We'll figure that out. So right now, I am Nissa Turin. I'm a ranger slash hunter. I'm also a rock gnome.
Nice combination.
Yeah. Lawful good. Older looking young adult female.
All right.
Hilarious.
And presumably that will change over time.
My ideals are change. Life is like the season in constant change. We must change it. And I have little practical experience dealing with people, and I love a good insult, even if it's directed at me. Wow, I must stick with this person. This is basically me in real life. An older-looking young adult female.
Screw this mimic concept. Just stick with that one.
Yeah, fuck that.
All right. So the story so far. There was, as Keith described it, a douchebag in the sky who was saying that pretty much, yo, I'm gonna end the world unless you, like, fight me in a week.
What a douchebag.
Yeah.
1v1 me and Baron Pit Nerd.
Pretty much. And so they've been on a quest across the country to get to the Crypt of the Void. They started in the Always Tavern because they always start in a tavern.
It's always a tavern.
They visited King Maz and King Shire Castle. They passed through the pits of the Howling Mines to the Steel Magnolia, Magnolio's Club. They managed to conquer...
Yeah, about Magnolio.
Well, not anymore.
Is Magnolio dead oleo? I don't know.
He might have gotten a bit toasted.
But it's okay, because we had a farmer on hand.
They had an effect, like they had one of those Rod of Wonders effects where they're rolling on the giant table, and the effect they got is all flowers within 60 feet die.
Including a magnolia.
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess that counts, sure.
He had a flower for a head, so he died.
What a sad thing.
Connection? Like, that really just comes down to your internet. See if there's anything else that's bothering it.
Including turning off your camera.
If it comes down to it.
Yeah.
Well, Discord's still open, and I should probably close that.
That would help. So then they conquered the obligatory ice level by no-clipping through the invisible walls.
That whole sentence is my favorite thing we've ever said. I love the fact that all of that exists.
It was so good.
How did they do that? Someone playing as a hacker? Like, how did that happen?
No, they just kind of like one of them went into a corner and just wiggled until they got it.
Oh, old Doom speedrun tactics. I get it.
Yeah,
exactly.
After that person,
I gave him a hammer to aid him.
Carson here just fucking knocked down the invisible walls. Because, 160 fire damage will do that.
It will. That will knock out quite a bit.
For each dollar you donate towards the hammer fund, my hammer grows in size. Right now, it is 51 times the normal size of a warhammer.
Holy shit.
For each creature that I kill with a hammer, I will donate $1.
Wow. Dope.
Yeah.
And last fight, I cast Enlarge on him, so that was a very big hammer.
I was very big.
So,
fighting for something.
They passed through the Manor of the Soul, in which they fought themselves.
Very nice.
Why gotta not? Fight your inner demons, man.
Pretty much.
To fight the giant space demon.
And save the undead encampment by defeating Ornstein and Smo.
Oh, of course. And I gotta do that.
And so now you are headed to the final challenge before the crypt itself, the Fated Bastion.
Beep boop.
Of course. That means... Oh, by the way. at the end of that, you passed out because magic and time. And 2 days remain.
Oh no. 2 days?
Days.
Alright. But part four.
Dun, 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 dun.
Ooh, ooh, I like this. I like the sound of this.
Glad to please.
I didn't hear music. Was there music?
Oh, did you not? Right, I'll play it again.
I heard it. Unless it's only on my computer's making random noises.
No, I tried to play music.
Sounded like adventure starting music.
Yeah, Fred, is your master music turned off? It'd be under your settings.
What am I doing?
I mean, I can hear you guys okay.
Yeah, but it would be the master music volume. It would mean I can play stuff or not.
Is Fred's video black on everyone else's?
Yeah, that's on purpose.
I need to restart.
Everybody tried to talk at once. Sorry, what?
I tried. Oh, yeah. No, my master music volume's all the way up.
All the way up? Really? I'll try playing it again and see if you hear it.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, nothing.
No, I can even see that you're playing it in the chat box.
That's super weird. All right, well, I guess you just can't hear music.
Okay. What?
Sorry, what, Josh?
Try refreshing.
Okay, yeah, I'll go ahead and try refreshing. Right. I'm just gonna restart the browser. I'll be right back. For it.
What are you say? Are you trying to say something, Josh?
Disconnected.
No,
he is frozen.
Should I my
internet
things?
Fred
now.
Hey,
you have a thing too. Look at you go. You're like a real person.
Josh, try and close your browser and open it back up again. It might be that you just have too much stuff cached or something.
Clear your cache and cookies. Turn it back on again. Close all your windows.
There we go. Good to see you, Fred.
Put an earth magnet on your
hard drive. Beautiful as always.
Delete system
32. Oh, I hear that one works 100% of the time.
Oh, yeah, every time. I mean, like, there's nothing that it won't clear.
I've never done it, and it didn't fix everything. Because I could not use my computer anymore, which is probably the cause of most of my issues.
Yeah, using computers are bad. Hey, Josh, awesome. Try and say something.
Hello.
Technology is the devil.
All right, cool. Seems like it's working.
Technology is the devil. Okay.
All right, let me just grab some random image. So you approach the faded bastion from the trail after introducing itself to each other.
Hello.
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 A hammer.
You're not one of those elves, are you?
Who, I?
Yes.
Define elf.
As in, you don't suffer from those birth defects, do you? If you do, I apologize. Your mother must have been a terrible drunk.
My mother was a saint, sir. Like, actually canonized.
His mother was actually a terrible drunk.
I roll religion on his mother. Zero.
You believe it wholeheartedly.
a saint.
You are aware of Saint Secox's mom.
A saint.
Is that intelligent? Saint. Oh yeah.
Is his character even an elf? I actually don't know.
I think he's a half elf.
Oh. So he's only kind of malformed then.
No.
But he also you You don't know of this saint, but definitely can't disprove it.
I definitely know that there might be a saint.
Like, I don't know. I've never heard of that saint, but there's a lot of saints I haven't heard of.
I mean, why? Just for the hell of it, I'll think about it for a brief second.
Sure. You're pretty sure that that's not a real thing.
Yeah. That's, I'm,
wait a second.
You know, you people would say anything to defend their mother's honor. I'm pretty sure you're lying.
That's no can do, sir.
No can do.
No can do on the lying there. Definitely.
I can't go for that.
Definitely no tell the truth.
See, friends, now this is a place. This is a location that I would want to be. It's got walls made out of stone. It's got good construction. It's got things I can hit with a hammer. This, I think, is the place we need to be.
It's got walls and it's away from people. That's all I need.
Oh, you're no fun.
Yes.
That's his character. Well, his whole character is that he's no fun.
If I had roll, one, I would plant a no fun. I would plant a no fun
on stone sign. Cunning. Give me a stone cunning history check about this stone castle.
So, these walls, although they do look like they're brick laden, were actually made with stone shaped spells, and that this was pretty much just built out of the mountain. And so even just though like, it looks like it was made piece by piece, it's pretty much like a single piece of stone, which makes it near unbreakable.
Well, that's convenient. I approach the front gate.
You are greeted by two men with halberds. They're like, halt!
I approach
the
man.
What is this establishment?
You have come to the
Fated
Bastion.
The last guard.
Oh, sorry, what?
It seems of dwarven slash magical construction.
You're not inaccurate. Kind of thought. You approach the Fated Bastion, the last guard between the world and the Crypt of the Void.
Yes, that's why we're here on business. We're going to go smash the thing.
We're going to break it.
Yes, what? We're going to smash the thing that's doing the bad.
With a hammer.
With a hammer. They notice the gigantic hammer dump truck sized thing that I'm carrying around behind me?
They do notice it.
You know, holy metric.
Someone said, hold on, what is being held?
Ah, I was going to approach them, but it seems like they're still doing their dialogue, so I'm...
Yep, dialogue's still going.
Interrupt.
So, there you go. We're not supposed to let people pass, because since it is a place of the gods, there's untold power there.
I see. And I pull up the magic key. Does this magic key do anything?
Okay, is this the real magic key or the fake magic key that you made?
I totally have the real magic key, which I pull out and have.
Right, but that is the one that you're holding up. Because you did make a fake magic key.
I did make a fake magic key. Don't tell me that I'm not going to be using it, because I will.
How fake and how magic?
It's an exact fake, duplicate of magic. The key, but not magical.
Wait, so it's fake magic?
Well, slightly magical, but not magical enough.
Presumably.
Well, the original key is magic, but the fake one isn't magic, so it's a fake magic key.
There you go.
That being said, I hold up the real magic key.
Okay. They do notice it. And they go into a long-winded speech that I'm not going to bother replicating the entirety of. But it's functionally about how, like, the universe is a cycle, and this is the natural progression of things, blah, blah, blah.
Okay.
Are we on a bridge?
May I interject?
Can we push him off the bridge?
No, before
you push it off the bridge, you're getting an interjection. So what's up?
As soon as they start talking about that, Keith steps forward. Excuse me.
You're excused.
I don't think you understand. We have the key. He has that hammer, and I have this belt. If you do not let us pass, I will give you 5 across the ass. What, I'm going to roll for an intimidation check.
I think that you need to calm down. Fuck you.
Can I roll to...
That did not work. Him?
Can you do
it? Can I roll to like back up his claim?
Secox wants to be his hype man.
I'm going to be a hype man. So do I roll it? What would I roll?
Oh, he's about to do it.
Roll intimidation if you're trained in it. Otherwise, either persuasion or bluff.
I am
I also have deception.
Yeah, but you're rolling intimidation on this one.
Well, yeah, I rolled. It did not work out well. Unless you want me to re-roll.
No, that was fine. You don't get to re-roll. It's not how these work. We'll find out if your backup is gonna make it stick for you.
Yeah.
Because that was some good idea.
What do I roll to also hype man?
While they're talking, okay, my hammer is suffused with holy energy and grows 20 times more sizes.
Is that right? Someone give you $20 more?
All right, I did that thing.
Yep.
Oh my god.
Hammer grew so they're talking, and then they suddenly notice that
growing in the background. All right, yeah, that's pretty solid.
I shift the weight onto my other shoulder, and I talk to the gods while they're being like accosted by this man with a belt, and I say, listen, okay, we've got a lot of gogi stuck up in this hammer, and it's gotta go somewhere evil, otherwise it's gonna go right up our asses, so maybe we should hurry this along, please?
All right, I'm like, fine, we will ask the people inside, just don't murder us. Hold on. And so
we didn't say nothing about murder. We say just giving lashes on the ass.
Well, I mean,
we're not barbarians.
No death
lashes
involved.
On the ass with his belt. They'll live.
We're
lashes
not
on
barbarians.
The ass with that hammer. They're toast.
At the very least, the broken pelvis.
You're gonna tell me you haven't broken your butt? Come on now.
From a lash in.
Right. So, all right, so they're letting us pass. I disconnected a little bit.
They're letting you into the fortress. Whether they let you out the other side is another question.
Okay. So.
Yeah, well, sweet. I have a blowgun.
That is sweet. Okay, so they bring you inside, and there is an assortment of like soldiers and knights and stuff, and they're like, we hear that you are the chosen one. We will let you pass, but only if you are prepared.
Prepared how?
Definitely chosen, maybe not the one.
Face our champion in single combat.
Yo, our boy here got that.
The one with the key?
Yo, he's telling you, you a bitch, but you ain't no bitch.
No, is he talking to me, the one with the hammer?
You get to pick from among yourselves.
Yo, the one with the hammer, though. Look at him.
I mean, he does have the key.
The building.
The hammer is like the size of one of those. It's an 18 wheeler on the end of a stick. Okay.
Yeah, you got this, boy.
Man, I think he's got this.
You gonna tell me you don't got this, son? You got this harder than you know even know. I know more about you got this than you got this.
He's definitely got this.
I volunteer to fight your dude.
Definitely need to just hit him until we can get past.
All right.
Hit him until he stops
setting us up.
Hit him until the door opens.
Probably just hit him once. It'd be good enough.
All y'all bitches over here.
Sorry. If you die, then at least you die in motion.
Okay. So, they bring you across, they bring you in, like, through the bridge to an area that looks like this.
Yo.
Okay.
And you see the big-ass dude in the middle of the ring.
Is he a big dude? He's How big is the guy?
Oh, bro, you got this. You got this. Just get down.
Yeah, you should see. Got this.
Like, what do you
Did we ever rest? Did we rest after the fight?
We actually took an extended rest because you all just, like, magically passed out.
Great, though.
Magical extended rest.
Pretty much.
Oh, okay. Let me undo this and undo this. Let me give me back all my spell slots.
All right, while you guys are figuring out what you need to do for the fight, I'm going to run to the bathroom real quick. Be right back.
I mean, don't we have that pretty figured out? You're just going to hit him until the door opens.
Yeah.
What stat does poning come off of? The strength or intelligence? Shame there's no handsome stat.
You could disable receiving video. That might help.
Oh, yeah. You just turn our names on? Or just make it our names?
I mean for Josh, because he was having issues.
That's a feature that I remember.
Yeah, like you can broadcast your video, but then turn off the video from everyone else. That might help the lag.
Okay. Yeah, because I turned off a video for myself.
But if you flip that. Yeah.
Okay.
All right. Everybody ready?
All right. Single combat, you said.
Yep.
Okay.
Hammer guy,
I make a perception check on the big dude.
He's a big
dude. To determine if he's some kind of like construct or something made out of stone.
He appears to just be some like energy being in armor.
An energy being in armor. Does it seem to be an elemental?
Not really. It's closer to an Archon.
Okay. Well, I'm ready to face him.
All right.
It's just going to be 1v1.
Yep.
All right. Yeah. I'll, he's awfully big. Here, hold on. I'm gonna give you a, little pat on the back. Make you a little bigger.
Okay.
Is he allowed to do that?
Technically, no. But if, if Andrew wants to make a quick bluff or perform check to make it look like he's doing it himself.
Do you want to attempt this?
No, I grab his hand when he tries to make me big, and I say, no, this is the field of honor where we must face them honorably, you know, with my own magics.
Fair enough.
Don't you worry your pretty little beard.
Get him, nerd.
Hang on, actually, there we go, 71 times, and this is coming up correctly, okay, I step into the ring and roll initiative.
Okay.
Can I hype him up?
Ding.
Can we start throwing in chairs for him 21. To use? What is there near us that we can throw him to use?
Not a whole lot.
The people around.
You could throw dollars into donations to make the hammer bigger, is what you could do.
You could also, like...
Could I provide a soundtrack?
Yeah, you could provide background music.
Sure.
If your music is inspiring, I can't stop you from inspiring.
Why not use one of the songs that Steve requested?
Sure. What was it? Bad Boys? All right. So you step in the ring.
And I start playing the music.
Yeah. Okay. Cool. So take a step forward, just because you're not supposed to, like, you would have to have been in the ring for the bell to ring.
Boom. Right,
cool. So it's going to take its, it's going to approach you and take a swing with its big ass sword.
Okay.
What level are we, by the way?
Eight.
I think we're still level eight.
That will not hit. I have 21 AC now.
All right, go ahead then.
Good googly moogly. See, I told you you got this, bro. You got this.
Okay. Does it have extra attack or anything?
Oh, that's it right now.
Okay. I'm going to wind up the most perfect golf swing that you've ever seen and bring the hammer right to bear in its chest and cast the spell Banishment on it. Make a charisma save.
All right. Does a 15 make it?
The 15 just makes it. So
okay.
I attempt to disrupt its form and send it back to its home plane. But I miss and just do a comical spin around with this giant heavy hammer.
Oh, okay, so you don't actually hit him.
Ooh.
Okay.
It's all right. He's playing for the crowd.
Yeah.
I get a little bit dizzy.
I'm gonna give him a name. How about like Iron Fist? There we go.
Call him Thangob.
Thangob? I like it.
Thangob
Iron Fist.
Thangob Iron Fist.
There you go. So he's gonna take a swipe at you with the sword again.
Try it.
23.
That will hit. But I cast the spell Shield.
Oh shit. Nice. He's also gonna try and grab you. But I doubt that'll work with the shield.
You pretty much have to crit. It's like athletics. It's like opposed athletics, and he tries to grab me, and I grab his thumb.
It only actually matters if he's trying to, like, if he actually succeeded.
Oh, okay. All right.
My
turn.
Yep, go ahead.
I hit him with a hammer.
You hit him with a hammer.
Jesus.
Okay, how do I even read this? So it's 14 damage.
Okay, so it does 14 plus 178 plus 22 plus an extra 7, and then if it's a construct, it takes 8 force damage.
Okay, it's not a construct, so I'm just going to use...
Okay, it does not take 8 force damage. It takes the rest of that, though.
Okay, one sec.
So that's 21 plus 22. It's 43.
Let's see if I can use order operations in this or not. He can. Cool. He takes 132 because he's resistant to fire.
Oh, wait. Sure.
Hold on a second.
Alright, he is bloodied but alive.
He is bloodied but alive, you say?
Yeah.
Shit. Well, see him try and hit me.
Punk. Okay. He's going to use his flurry. So first he's going to go for the sword swipe. Hit the last.
Well, I'm gonna cast the shield spell because I don't care.
Doesn't matter. And then he's going to go for a energy blast. So this is a dex save.
Oh, that is something that I am not good at. That is a thing that I have never once succeeded in my life.
Oh no!
I to never succeed at.
Could I roll to convince him that he did succeed? And maybe he just believes. He didn't believe hard enough that first time?
Sure. Roll a persuasion check to have Andrew roll again.
All right.
Let's see just
what
how
is your
convincing
character?
Secox is.
Like turbo bard?
Pretty much. He's a very talkative man.
You got this, man.
All right, you can take another crack at it, but this time you have disadvantage.
I believe in you.
Oh, that's even worse.
Right.
Give me the energy
you
blast.
You didn't fail me. You failed yourself.
What kind of damage is that?
That's all that matters.
And then
what
he's
kind of damage is it?
To you, but I think he's not going to be able to actually hit you through your shield.
He could crit. What kind of damage was that, though? The energy?
Oh, radiant. Like
shit kind of damage.
Was it lightning?
No, it was radiant.
Radiant, okay. Yeah. Okay.
All right.
My turn.
Finish him.
Hit it with a hammer.
Finish him.
What a gripping complex. Yep, that'll do it.
Complex.
It's very hard.
I hit it very hard.
He's pretty dead. Oh. Bam.
Damn.
You knock it over and the energy just leaks out of the suit.
What happens to it?
The energy leaks away after you knock the suit over.
Okay. Hang on a second. I cast Healing Word.
On it?
I cast Healing Word to try and bring its spirit back, because I'm a Forge Master.
All right, yeah, no, you bring it back with Platoon. It is somewhat confused, but stands up, puts its sword away, and shakes your hand.
I lift it. Yes, I lift it, and I shake his hand.
Okay. It is lifted. The crowd is stunned, but eventually cheers.
Incredible.
Just give me a truck. Give me a truck for a hammer.
So an incredibly old man comes down from the level above, who had been watching.
It's that big. It's like swamp.
Pretty much. And he's like, clearly these people are above what we should be messing with. Just send them on their way.
Get out.
Nah, fight us all. We can take the whole castle. We'll have a castle for us, guys.
As I pass them, I strum my lute intimidatingly.
By the way, I was so impressed with you beating the shit out of that dude with your truck size hammer that I shifted, mostly because I misclicked on the screen and it changed everything.
Yeah, I don't even see where Keith is, to be honest.
I'm Larissa Random.
That's fair. You're probably somewhere under the ocean.
Yeah, I don't know where Keith is.
That's a good question. Where is Keith?
Is that the ocean?
I mean, it's water.
No, please, not the ocean. Anything but that.
Yeah,
anything but water. I can't do that.
He's gone.
How the ocean get in our space castle?
I received another donation for about $10, so that brings me up to the mystery gift.
Oh, cool. What's that do?
The reward is called Kiss from a Rose, and it says Keith will receive a mysterious item from afar that will aid him in encounters later.
Nice.
So, yes, it is a song. That's why I put that.
Do we get to hear the song?
Perhaps.
Like cultured gentlemen that we are.
One sec. Let me see if I have access to it quickly. Or if this will just be obnoxious.
Josh has to sing it. No.
Oh, all right. Well, yeah, go ahead and sing it then.
Can you find a karaoke file?
No, I can't find even the real one.
Damn.
Could you try and sing a few bars?
I can try.
Give it a shot.
I compare you to a kiss from a rose on the grave. Ooh, the more I get of you, the stranger it feels, yeah. Now that your rose is in bloom, a light hits the gloom on the grave.
I'm not the only one hard, right?
Sold as a rock.
Not bad.
Thank you.
I'd kiss your rose, Josh.
Not before marriage.
Not even married.
Well, what else did you have for us in this citadel of citadelitude?
Mostly,
just fighting that dude?
They're pretty much here to set you up for whatever you think you'll need for your final fight. Supported. Like, this is a fortress. They are ready for whatever it is that may come. And you are now the chosen champions to pretty much fight a god.
So would one of them be giving me the item? Or...
Yeah, sure. One of them hands you a box. It's like, I don't know if this will come in handy, but like maybe you'll enjoy it.
Hmm.
And it's about this big.
Okay.
Bonus. Can't see what you're doing because I have video disabled on you.
Oh.
Everybody else.
Sorry.
Do they have boots?
Do
they have magic boots?
You can find some boots. Boots and cats. I'm trying to think of a good comparison for a size. It's like maybe like 8 inches.
Shoebox?
About half a shoebox.
Okay.
Anyway, there's a gelatinous cube inside.
Shoebox for toddlers.
You gave me gelatin.
It's acid.
That's a gelatinous cube.
Yeah, it's a 6-inch by 6-inch cube of acid.
Neat. Like just a block of acid.
Pretty much, yeah.
Okay, right, okay.
I have a question. Is it the hurdy kind of acid or the fun kind of acid?
It's the hurdy kind of acid.
Everything's the fun kind of acid, you just gotta look at it a different way.
Man
speaks truth.
I am looking for a bag of holding and a portable hole.
Wait, okay. This man needs somewhere to keep his hammer.
If I give those to you, are you going to do things with them? Like together?
Or are you just gonna do things.
All right, pick whether you want a bag of holding or a portable hole. The other one will be conveniently unavailable.
Oh, man. That's terrible.
You also get boots of spider climbing because you wanted special boots.
I wanted boots of water walking, if that's an option.
That works
because
too.
Because I hate water so much.
Boots of water walking are also an option.
What did water ever do to you, man?
You have no idea.
You didn't get hit by a hammer. That's what happened.
True. You can't beat water with a hammer unless you try real hard.
Yeah.
Oh, believe me,
I've really
tried.
Cold.
Ice is a completely different thing. All right,
fine. We're gonna argue ice semantics. That's fine.
Anybody else need some form of gear?
Could I find a set of plate armor?
Sure.
Okay.
That's super simple. You find plate armor. Done.
Great toe.
Okay. Let me just finish looking through this the Dungeon Master's Guide, and I'll tell you if they've got a thing.
Pardon?
Hmm.
The DMG.
I mean, aside from the cube of acid, I really don't know what else Keith would... And I have the shield from that one guy, so I'm not sure what else I would need for the upcoming battle.
If you think you're set, then you're set, and we can just go right on to the crypt.
I guess maybe Keith looks for a new song sheet.
Okay, sure. He will find your the ones that we added to your character sheet that you conveniently didn't have until now.
All righty then.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think I'm set then.
Okay.
Okay. Can I get boots of levitation?
What is different between that and water walking boots?
Boots of levitation. Well, there is no water walking boots, first of all.
Really? Well, fine. Yes. Now there
are. I think
that's
a ring of water walking.
Whatever. There are water walking boots now. Doesn't really make that much of a difference.
Right.
There also isn't a, like, baby gelatinous cube that you can keep in a box. Or a race of perfectly transforming mimics.
Doesn't matter. It's just a thing.
Exactly.
Oh, I meant to ask. I'm gonna roll this is not necessarily a question so much as it is a statement.
Okay.
I'm gonna roll a perception check on that cube of acid to see if I can figure out anything.
Okay.
Oh, wait a minute.
You okay?
Apparently, the initial donation, well, not only did it get me up, the other donation not only got me up to the mysterious gift, but it also, but I also, well, because of it was a $10 donation, I'm supposed to, the next song I sing in battle will have to be Eye of the Tiger.
Okay.
See, but, Eye of the Hammer, it's the will of the fight.
Rising with up the donations.
Survival.
Hammer.
Oh, do they have, this is probably a long shot, but would they have a javelin of, like a lightning javelin?
Oh, yeah.
Javelin of lightning?
Why not?
Oh, yeah. Nick, I rolled a perception check on that cube of slime to see if I can figure out how it would react when, like, touched.
Oh, it would burn you.
Oh, well, yeah. I wasn't sure how it would react. Like, say, if I were to use, if I were to, like, put the pick for my loot into it, if it would just destroy it or if it would augment it. Is it pick
plastic or metal?
Let's just say, for the sake of argument, metal.
It's fine. Doesn't burn metal.
Okay, but it would probably destroy the loot.
Yeah.
Probably. Would they have a javelin of lightning or no?
Sure.
Okay. Cool. I'm all set to go then.
Well, next song is Eye of the Tiger, or, well, I will probably use the songs that Steve requested first, and then Dave's, because that's how order works.
Okay.
Anyway.
So are we moving on? What's up?
I'm ready to go if you guys are.
Hang out.
I've got my ring of water walking. And can I get a robe of useful items?
Is that a real thing? Or is that just something you want?
Yes. It's got useful items on it. Like a bunch of just weird things. Oh, it's in the DMG.
Yeah,
the
sure,
robe of patches, the robe of useful things.
Yeah.
I take it.
That's cool.
All right.
So now I am a fighter gnome.
All right.
Just saying. And I fight with a trident and a sling.
That's pretty sweet.
I finally got the whole random character generator down, so we're good. Sweet. Let's go.
Okay.
Take what they give me.
You progress, and you notice that, like, as you're going, so you take some time there to make sure you're, like, prepared and, like, fully ready to go. And as you're going to the Crypt of the Void, you notice that the world is really quiet. There's, like, no birds, no bugs, just nothing. Not even wind. It's real weird here.
Ominous.
Medicine.
I like it.
I can't hear anything.
What?
What?
It's well, just there's really no sense in delaying the inevitable.
Hey, shh. Everything's really quiet.
Okay.
What are we doing? let's go.
So you're heading to the Crypt of the Void, and when you get there, you find it's like a big ass metal or stone door with, like, metal filigree, and it's, like, it's very fancy. And with a tiny keyhole in the, like, dead center.
Okay.
Hey, you have the key. It's called a big hammer.
I hit it with a hammer.
All right. Go ahead, try.
Hit it with a hammer.
Okay, I need you to make a dexterity saving throw real quick.
8.
Oh, yeah, that's not going to work. You get pushed. A 100 feet away.
No problem.
Luckily, like, you are able to slow your fall to the point where it doesn't just wreck you on a tree. But...
Hey, man, we all make mistakes.
I'm telling you, dude, boots of levitation.
I mean, then you just fly back with no friction.
Anyway,
well, I guess I should use the key.
Yeah,
you. We were saving it for later.
Saving it for marriage.
You know how these boss dungeons go. You use the key, and then it breaks in the keyhole, and you have to break open some pots until you find a new one.
That's terrible.
So you open the, you put the key in and turn it, and the keyhole like gleams and then disappears, and the door itself starts to shimmer and then just disappears. So now there's just a big, like, gaping hole.
Gaping hole. My favorite kind
of hole.
Hold
yourselves in readiness, friends.
I firmly grasp my belt.
Firmly grasp it.
Firmly grasp it. That belt has never been grasped more firmly. Firmly?
Grasp. I have it with both hands.
Oh, he's got it. All right, let's go. Let's do it.
Right. Let's do it. You journey into the temple. And so you proceed inside, and there are, it's a long hallway, and on...
Actually, wait. Before we enter, yes. I ritual cast the spell Divination, which allows me to ask the gods one question.
Okay.
They say no.
And my question is, are we going to be able to defeat the evil within this temple?
One sec, I need to write you a poem.
if you want to, okay, I guess so. If you want to write us a poem, that's fine.
Well, I mean, it needs to be suitably cryptic,
lyrical, and all that.
Spooky.
Yeah.
I think we just burn the whole thing down.
Let's just kill everybody.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think we're on the same page, man.
So you see me sitting in a trance for like 10 minutes in front of this open, gaping doorway. and then I just say, the world within is of no concern. But try and fail, the world may burn. But why is it of no concern?
Why?
That's concerning.
Why can't you just speak normally?
Why can't you, you... lyricist?
Ooh. Dude, because I don't need rhymey, whimey bullshit.
Isn't it literally a part of your repertoire? As a kind of singer-songwriter?
It was.
Shut up.
Shh. Okay, fine then. Let's go.
Okay.
Okay.
As you proceed, there is the long, long hallway, and there are murals on the walls with like what look like hieroglyphs from some ancient language you don't speak.
Stone cutting.
Okay. You can tell that this has been here for a long, 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 long time. Like probably before part of this continent existed. Like this stone is old stone.
Interesting.
And the murals within it are showing a story of like a people that aren't remembered anymore, worshiping a god whose name is forgotten for a purpose that no one really knows. And how those people fell to ruin.
Well, nuts.
Wow.
Well, I understand the first part of your rhymey whimy nonsense. This doesn't matter.
Astute observation.
Relevant.
Are you like storming down the hallway?
No, I stopped to look at it for a minute, and I hear that explanation, and I'm like, and then I turn and storm away.
Gotcha.
Give me 1 second. I think my thing just exploded.
Okay.
I'm gonna roll.
I begin perception. Ritual casting the spell silence. Shit.
I get
mask on footsteps.
Okay.
What is that?
What were you trying to roll, Fred?
I was trying to roll perception to see if like anything right, could be figured out about like what's going on.
Yeah, you know.
But radiant sphere is silent.
It's quiet.
Yeah, it's quiet.
I turn back.
Quiet time.
And I. Where is it? And I turn back and do a perception check on the wall to see if maybe there's a clue as to how to deal with whatever we're about to face.
Oh, sweet crit. So you realize that the story actually doesn't end there, although there is it gets more faded as you go. It shows as the society is falling to ruin, there's the gods of that society and each of them disappearing one by one until there's only one left. And then that one, it's pretty much the same picture over and over and over of that one, with like the city under it crumbling and turning to dust, not like by interaction, but just by time. And the final picture of the hieroglyphs is of the god reaching down over a treasure chest with 5 golden rings floating over it. Yep, you got it. You just need to go get Sonic the Hedgehog. He is the key to saving the world.
No.
Sonic is the god.
No.
We're going to fight a god of speed.
No. This god is throwing a temper tantrum because no one's paying attention to him. Obviously, this is Shadow the Hedgehog.
I thought you didn't believe in gods.
You sure it's just not some guy who's upset that the color of Sonic's arms were changed?
Wait,
why
what?
The fuck is he wearing a bandana now?
A lot of people lost their minds when the new Sonic
stupid
had his arms
ass blue. God.
Sonic community is weird.
Those speedruns are works of art, though.
Oh, God. Most speedruns are, though.
Okay. Anyway,
yeah.
Moving on. Let's walk down the hallway.
Silently.
Okay. Silently. In absolute silence.
As
no
you progress,
talking.
Bring out a pot.
What? Right.
Secox takes out his cooking utensils and starts banging them together as loud as he can.
It's still silent.
So you proceed down the hall and you come to a although it seems like the hall continues going down, you come to a door on your right, which would be the first door you found so far.
Okay, I sidle up to the door and I put my ear to it and I roll a perception check to see if there's anything on the other side.
You do not hear anything of note.
Okay, I open the door.
All right, neat.
We all stand ready.
And then I get on the floor. Somebody polymorph me into a dinosaur.
Everybody do
a dinosaur. Keith lightly strums the opening chords to walk the dinosaur.
Gotcha.
And then goes into a battle-ready stance.
One sec, I need to Fred, how should I refer to your character as a whole?
Just call me Gimble right now.
Gimble? Alright. Need to break out good old number one for Secox.
Gimble full core.
Okay. Secox. Okay. Since there is no immediate threat, I'm going to put you inside the room, just for simplicity's sake.
Put me in, coach. I'm ready to play today.
Whoa. So you look in, and there's this big mirror, and on the what you see on the other side of the mirror is what is being reflected in it.
So like, all that stuff is on the other side? The
side is what the reflection is.
Oh. So this stuff here is not on this side?
Well, no, this stuff, this stuff on this side is what you see, is what's here. Mm. Like, it's physical objects. Okay. On this side is what you see in the mirror.
Okay.
Oh, sick.
Look at Judge Mika.
Mirrors.
Wait, is this just man in the mirror?
There, I noticed that these mirrors are decidedly not symmetrical.
I stop you and notice that there are two treasure chests here. This is some bullshit. That mural showed only one treasure chest.
One of them's a vampire treasure chest.
Well, aren't you a mimic? Isn't this your field of expertise?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Well, this
room can you try and call out to your mimic brethren? The mating call of the mimic?
He's a method actor. He doesn't remember what being a mimic is.
I'm not that kind of mimic.
I'm not that kind of mimic.
That is a dirty mimic stereotype, and I'm not going to talk to you anymore.
People mimics don't really approve of our treasure chest wielding brethren.
Is there some kind of like plinth or plaque on the ground with some kind of cryptic riddle?
I mean, there are plaques.
I'm gonna roll.
Does it say something? Check. Is it like a
pattern?
I'm gonna roll a perception check on both of the on each of the treasure chests.
Okay. And when you say both, what do you mean?
Well, like, on the one on the left, I want to roll for one on the left and one on the right.
Okay, so let's look at the one on the left first.
Examine both of them.
The one on the left appears to be a treasure chest. Like, I'm not entirely sure what you're looking for.
I'm looking for anything that would look out of place.
Oh, okay. Nothing upon immediate examination is out of place, except for the fact that it doesn't have a reflection.
Wait, what's the...
Well, right, I've had just about enough of this. I move over to the statue, and I make an athletics check to push it over to this trap thing.
Oh, that's actually another treasure chest.
What?
Like, I guess it doesn't really look like it, but that's
what that symbol's another treasure chest?
Well, you see a reflection of a treasure chest without there being one here. Mm-hmm. Oh. And this one doesn't have.
Oh, no, not that. No, what is this? What is this?
Sorry, could you do the push again? Oh, okay, that is just a recess on the ground. But go ahead, yeah, you can go push push the statue.
I push the statue into the recess in the ground.
Okay.
Because Mama didn't raise no sucker.
Right, make a strength check. All right, you're going to have some issues, so it'll take some time.
If there's two of these things, if there's
I'm going
two
over to help.
No. If there's two recesses in the ground, then we should treasure chests since they're identical items.
What?
Like, you notice how there's two recesses in the ground here, and each of these items is unique. Like, none of them look exactly like the other ones except for the treasure chests.
Oh. Okay.
I think I say we move the treasure chests.
To the recesses?
Yes. Plus,
well, by that logic, why don't we just move over here to this dragon statue and pick it up?
All right, you can try to pick up the statue. You succeed to pick up the statue.
I move it down and over and put it down on this...
No, I'm telling you, we should move the treasure chest. I say as I do that athletics check there.
Keith Troubadour is trying to touch this treasure chest.
Yeah, he's trying to touch the treasure chest and he's pushing it very poorly.
I move this dragon statue onto the to the indentation.
Okay.
Okay. Does the dragon statue attack us?
No.
Okay.
Nothing on the
reflection. Properly. Yes. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay.
I move over to this treasure chest, and I push it onto the other indentation.
Okay. This one is like kind of stuck to the floor, like so it's like got some weird like jelly under it.
Mimic jelly.
Which one?
The treasure chest you were just trying to push.
Meanwhile, yeah, I am still trying to move the other treasure chest.
Okay, you got it on the second one, but where are you putting it? Because there's currently a giant statue there.
I move it right so that it's right next to the dragon.
Here.
Realize there's a dragon there. Realize the statue's there, and then say an expletive that I won't bother repeating.
All right.
Okay. Do I hear any click?
No.
Of a trap? Well done.
Can you please move?
No.
Yeah,
okay.
No. I move over to the
statue. And I kind of move its sword blades so that it's symmetrical with its mirror.
Oh, that's supposed to be the case. I just can't make it do it.
Oh, okay.
That's fine, never mind then.
Yeah, that's just
never mind.
Okay, so that's just a technical thing.
Yeah, all the rest is accurate. That's messed up. I think this might be the same thing where like, yeah, it's
all right. I go over.
Perfect.
To the dragon statue.
All right, Keith, do you have it in you? You do not.
I told you. Sort of fumbles with the dragon statue. It does that thing where you know you push against someone like crazy, but your entire upper half is like doing nothing before he slips.
I'm gonna stand here.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, right. It's like we're not doing anything.
You walk over there and slam your knees into something invisible.
Okay.
Ouch.
So you get to here before that happens.
I pick up this. Wait, what's the deal with the treasure chest over on the left? Is it like covered in goo?
It's just as gooey as the one on the right. In fact, now that you've seen both, could you roll a perception check for me, Mountaincrag? Never mind. They're just treasure chests.
Okay. I move this treasure chest over here and put it right there.
So before you do that, Austin's character name, whose name is being covered, what did you want to do something with the thing that you just bumped into?
I just said ow, and I'm just going to sit here and let the smart people do things.
All right. Okay, so you move, you pick up the treasure chest. Do you pick it up or are you pushing it?
I'm pushing it.
Okay. So you push it along the ground and I need to scoop this so I can get at it. You push it along the ground and you get it to about here. Presumably Fizzlebottom gets out of the way. But then you can't push it into that spot because it's being pushed up against something.
Mm. Okay. Well, then I'm going to try and touch the invisible thing and see if there's like a latch that I can open.
Okay. Do you want to possibly use your reflection as a guide?
Absolutely not. I'm going to fumble blindly just looking at my hands.
All right, cool. roll a sleight of hand check.
That's not a thing that I'm good at.
No. Oh, but you get there. You eventually fumble and find the latch and open it. And once it's open, it is no longer invisible.
Whoa.
Da, 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 da.
What the?
Okay, well, what's...
Mirrors!
Is there anything inside of it?
Everywhere.
Yeah, inside of it is a astral diamond.
Dope.
Okay.
Which is worth a preposterous amount of money.
No, you mean that it is a preposterous amount of spell components for spells like Revivify.
Did they really change that? No, because an astral diamond is like 1,000 platinum.
That's a preposterous amount of money.
Seems preposterous.
Whatever. It's a gemstone of incredible worth. If it's not that, it's something of similar.
Got it.
Yeah.
I'll take it.
Put it in your bum.
and you also find an assortment of completely unlabeled scrolls.
Hmm. I look at the scrolls and roll a... Well, and I roll perception to see what the scrolls are.
Okay. When you're looking a little closer, you see that they don't have any... Actually, you wouldn't know. They're just pieces of paper with writing on them.
I'm going to do an arcana check on the scrolls.
Okay.
Because I know stuff about magic.
They seem legit. They're just... It's magic paper. Does stuff with the wizards.
Sure is that magical doodads.
Hoo-wee, buddy.
Certainly is some
lucky
magic
day for you.
Hoo doggy.
Okay, I'm going to add
rocks to this place. Magic paper.
Is there like a path that we can go now?
Yeah, we could smash through this this thing here.
So much.
Nah, I'm gonna go over here and I'm gonna open this chest.
Okay.
Are you able to?
I'm gonna try.
Yeah. No, you successfully open it, and its mirror also opens, like its reflection does.
Right.
And inside is what appears to be a slingshot, and several like porous, like squish, almost like water balloons full of various substances.
I pocket all of them.
Nice. Wait, have we moved everything in this room? Or at least touch, like a
no, we haven't.
Some way?
We haven't moved
the dog statue two. Or that one. Yeah, he's right.
All
right,
I'm gonna open up the other. I'm gonna open up the other chest.
Wait! I gotta see what I got. do I have? What would figuring out what the things are be like? What's the balloons? Would that be like medicine or?
Probably arcana because they're probably magic.
Okay, I suck at arcana, so.
I could do a check for you. I'm pretty good at arcana.
Hey, Brumnar, Fizzlebottom, come check out my balloons.
Doing thing.
All right, let me inspect these magical balloons here.
I also want to roll a perception, I guess. On the slingshot, see if it's like what's the deal?
The slingshot is a eagle eye slingshot, so you have advantage when shooting at targets at like long range.
Sweet.
Mm-hmm.
So I guess I'm gonna be sniper makes snipey butt right now.
And the potion, the balloons, as far as Brumnar could tell. Are various potions presumably debilitating?
Presumably debilitating, not definitely
Infidious
debilitating.
Potions.
Yeah. All right. So you said you were going to open something, Keith.
Oh yeah, I'm going to open up the other chest.
Okay. So you go to open it, and so it opens, and it is a mimic.
Fuck.
Who'd have guessed?
Well, not only is it a mimic, it's a vampire mimic.
Oh my god, I called it.
Wait a second. It's as if someone said that.
That's why it doesn't have reflection, because it's a vampire.
Are you also a psychic?
Was that the plan the entire time?
Yeah.
No shit.
It's like you're a psychic.
All right, so you try to open it, and it's going to try to eat you.
Ah! Puppets! So
it's going to get advantage.
Well, that's a surprise.
Attack.
All right, so what do I...
11 plus 5. Does 11 plus 5 hit your AC? So it's a 16.
What do you mean?
Your armor class. Does 16 hit it?
My armor class is 13.
Still? Okay.
Yes.
You are going to... it's going to jump on your head and start trying to eat you.
Stupid goddamn puppetry!
There's some sound there.
You take 13, and the mimic moves onto your head.
Oh no, he's going to turn into a vampire. Then we'll have to kill him.
Oh no.
Alright, I'm going to try and get this thing off.
Everybody roll initiative. That was the surprise round.
Hey, a 12. That's nice.
20, fuck.
Nice.
Oh, I should probably roll.
I mean, if you want to fight, you can always just watch.
That's a much more Secox type thing. Hmm.
That was a joke. You should probably like at least.
I know.
How do I roll?
You're doing the wrong slash. You get the slash.
There you go.
Wait, was that rolling for initiative? Because I.
Yeah, you're in.
Right.
What the hell is that on this piece of paper?
There you go.
There it is.
Rip. I guess I'll go last.
Whoops. There was no B in there, guys.
123 initiative. Pretty good.
I think he's going first, man.
Could be.
Christ.
14. Alright. Okay, so, top of the order. Keith Troubadour. Things on your head trying to suck your blood. What's up?
All right. You forced me to do this.
This is going to hurt you a lot more than it's going to hurt me.
Fuck out my face. I take out the strap and I swing, trying to get it away from my head. Just trying to whack it off of my head with my belt.
All right. Go ahead. Make your attack. That'll hit. It takes 6 whipping damage.
The strap.
Off of my head!
It seems only slightly dissuaded. Alright, Secox, what's up?
Let me think here. So it's just the one dude?
Yeah.
Just the one dude.
Get it off of my head!
It's full of vampire.
Hit it with one of your silver rings. Straight backhand. Old pimp style.
It is on this guy's head, too.
Yeah.
Perfect backhand height.
Yeah.
Pull it off! Do something!
Convince it to convert to Christianity.
Can I convince Purehammer to pimp slap this thing?
You can try. Are you up into this mountain?
What do you do?
He's trying to inspire you to pimp slap the mimic.
Dude, the only thing that you can do here is to just smack him. Just punch him.
Pull
it off!
Pretty much.
Okay, try and inspire me.
Go ahead. Roll your persuasion. And if he succeeds, then you will get a free unarmed attack. To just backhand this thing.
Okay. Remember and 10. We'll do so.
There you go.
Oh, that'll do it. 25.
That's certainly a thing. All right.
You're right. That is the only thing I can do.
And then with
just punch him.
My movement, I'm going to go over here.
Nice.
I'm going to get behind my big, strong men.
All right,
Pure Hammer. Big, strong hammers and pin flaps.
All right, hang on giant one dicks. Second, please.
No trouble.
Hang on one second.
Please try not to pick off my head when you're getting this thing damage off of me.
Hang on.
And then there's going to be two turns of Keith getting hit in the face with a hammer.
Hang on.
I'm thinking.
Maybe we don't want to hit him in the face with a hammer.
Okay. Here's my hammer fist. Nice. I'll a 10 hit.
Oh my fucking god.
Miss. Okay.
Yeah, it'll miss. For the shot.
What's the point of having a giant hammer if you can't hit
me? That's literally his hand. He's just back at it.
Oh, never mind.
Oh, if you hit him with your hammer so hard and decapitate him, then the thing also comes off.
It's true.
The problem's solved.
Okay.
I would prefer to hit my head, thank you.
And I say, now hang on a second. In situations like this, it's important that you use finesse. And I put the truck-sized hammer down, and I pull out a normal-sized warhammer from my pack, and I cast Magic Weapon upon it, and then I hit the mimic with just a kind of big hammer.
Just a little big.
And mid-sized warhammer.
Roll the attack again, and this time against Josh's defenses.
Break both of Josh's knees.
Right. It's all right. You only take the original damage, though, so probably not much.
There it is.
Does a 14 hit your AC, Josh?
Oh, wait, what?
Does 14 hit your armor class?
Yeah, my armor class is, again, 13.
Okay, so you're going to take 13 damage as the Warhammer hits you in the shoulder.
God damn it. That was the most finesse.
That was the most finesse I've ever seen.
That was finesse. Just smooth as butter.
All right, I'm going to go over here, and I'm going to reach both arms on the sides of the mimic that are attempting to bite his head, and I'm going to try to wrench it off.
Just pry it open. All right, contesting strength check.
Pry it off.
Check would just be the thing plus the mod, right? So.
He's a 19.
That seems good.
Nice!
Strong
dwarf.
You have pried off the mimic. What do you want to do with it now that you're holding it with its mouth open?
I'm just going to keep it restrained and hold it in the air.
So it's going to take its turn and try to struggle its way out. Just repeat the contest. Oh,
Oh, son of a bitch.
Alright, so it's going to break free, but it is no longer on anyone's head. Alright, Gimble, you're up.
Okay, so I'm going to go stand fucking way back here. I'm going to try... Nah, over here is better. I'm going to try and cap this mimic with my new long-distance slingshot.
All right.
Like a man. Let's see.
The manniest.
How do I do ranged attacks?
You're not proficient with slingshots, so it's just plus your dexterity modifier.
Oh, wait.
I am proficient with simple and martial weapons.
Oh, okay.
Are we still at level 8, by the way, or are we level 9 now?
Level 8.
Slingshot level 9 later.
Yeah. Yeah, you're level 8 currently. You'll be level 9 once this encounter ends.
Yes.
Okay.
And then we'll take our final break for the night, and then we'll wrap up the campaign.
All right.
Okay, so do I roll a sleight hand? Dexterity, right?
Yeah.
To hit?
Yep.
Okay.
And then plus your proficiency, which would be, I think, 3 at this level?
Yeah. Plus.
Yeah, it is.
Who's one? No, but I think you have another three. I got you. Do you, you have a plus one dexterity?
Oh, no, yeah. 12
plus 3. Yeah.
Okay, so yeah, that, that'll be 15.
15.
And that'll be enough there to get the mimic.
Significantly less than
the mimic. You got the mimic with a sleeping draught. So it is asleep now.
Sweet.
Keith, do you want to get your revenge or just put some distance between you and it? Perhaps masterfully explode it?
I have a special spell for you.
You, wait, sorry.
Have, I'm going to serenade what? This thing. I'm sorry. I'm not thinking clearly. Oh, I've never been this angry. All right.
He was so angry for a second, he thought magic was real.
What kind of bullshit is this? All right.
Yeah, this is a vampire treasure chest trying to eat you.
Does it have
this
a heart?
This is a puppet. A prank by some punk kids.
What were you
some
saying?
Stupid wind-up boy.
Does it have a heart?
No.
We can't stake it?
No. You just need to destroy it. It'll die like a bitch like any other mimic.
We'll destroy its heart by destroying everything about
Brumnar.
It.
Brumnar, you're going to want to back up.
But, I mean, no, Master Exploder is a single target. You don't need to worry about it.
I didn't know if there was AoE effects.
Nah, it's fine.
All right.
I have enough health. It wouldn't even matter.
And
anyway.
Master Exploder!
It's a good song.
Just good song. So I just scream at the box.
All right, yeah, 18 will hit, and you are getting the wrong damage at that. Hold on. I have no idea why she's doing that. Let me find out. Oh, sorry, BL's the boss is not the boss. Oh, regardless, yeah, we'll do that.
Oh!
Yeah, BL's the boss.
He's on fire now.
Does it wake up?
Briefly.
Whoa. That's such a little
hype. Nice. Good effect.
Thank you. Alright. So, the mimic dies, and the mirror fades.
I knew we should just
everything was there. Real?
No. But that goes away. Except for the door. The door doesn't go away.
There's a door?
Well, the door that's the mirror is your door.
Oh, right. That makes sense.
Oh, the door was a mirror. Oh. Weird.
This mirror world.
Fuck. All the time.
Alright.
What are you doing? Your mouth, man.
Acting.
It was just playing.
There was one Dungeons & Dragons campaign that I was playing recently where all we did was method act. So when we were all in prison in a chain gang, I took out a whole bunch of handcuffs and rope, and we tied ourselves together, and we made our escape through a house. Method acting.
It's not how I thought that was going to end.
Method acting.
Method acting.
Why didn't you just method act free people? Then you wouldn't be in prison anymore. Yes.
Of course.
Of course.
Brilliant. All right, so...
we go through the door.
You open the door? All right.
Open the door. Get in there. Get all up in there.
It's moving. Hold on. Stay still.
Open the door. Get on the floor. Everybody walk in a dinosaur formation.
To walk the dinosaur.
Prepare all right,
can we have five people. Can we form a dinosaur?
You have the mask to pull it off, but you need a good spell for it.
Well, I turn around and give the room one final look while strumming Everybody Walk the Dinosaur aggressively as I leave.
We all start walking the dinosaur.
Where are we?
You are in a white featureless void with this pedestal in the middle and a chest.
Is there a keyhole in the chest?
There's not, but it doesn't appear to be locked.
Is there some kind of malevolent or godlike energy emanating from this chest or something?
Yes.
Okay.
Keith stays right where he is because fuck boxes.
All right. The question is, fuck is right. Are we level 9?
Yes.
All right. So how do we how do I distribute that?
Are we taking a break now?
Yeah. Let's take a break and we will discuss that when we get back.
All right.
Okay. See you in 10 minutes.